You're listening to the audio production of Carry the Flame Audio Bible Studies by Jim Cymbala, published by Harper Christian Resources and presented by the author. These audio studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, this production includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources.
Hi, this is Jim Cymbala, and I'm so happy that we can do this study together. Carry the Flame. It's for people who are not in the ministry, not on the platform, not ordained, didn't go to seminary, but the way we live our lives is all important for the Lord Jesus Christ, because God put it this way: you carry the flame. What is the flame? Well, it can be the flame of the light of the gospel that shines into people's lives, and from darkness, now they begin to see the meaning and purpose of life. It can be the flame of God's love that they begin to experience as they hear about the cross of Jesus Christ. So I want to talk in this series about how you and I, just regular folks, can carry the flame. So I want to take you to a passage in the book of Luke, chapter 10, and it reads this way, Luke chapter 10, verse 1. After this, the Lord appointed 70 others and sent them two by two ahead of him to every town and place where he was about to go. He told them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field." Most of us are aware of the 12 famous apostles, Matthew and James and John and the others, Thomas. But who are these 70 other people that he sent out? What was their role in the ministry of Jesus Christ? I think it's something very interesting that we need to ponder. They definitely didn't go to seminary. They weren't ordained. They never are mentioned by name in the Bible. They weren't one of the original 12, and yet he sent them out. Jesus sent them out to go ahead of him into the towns where he was about to visit. So without being named, they play a very important role in the ministry of Christ while he was on earth. And as he sent them out, he talked to them about their role, which was to go ahead of him, preceding him, paving the way for him. Isn't that a beautiful picture of how God wants to use you and I? That means you. Not just go to church on Sunday, but be available 24/7 to the Lord Jesus Christ so that we can pave the way for him. Go before him into people's lives, telling about him, talking about the salvation he offers, loving them in Christ's name, manifesting through our lives the kind of love and compassion that Jesus has for them. As he sent them out, Jesus said an amazing thing, which probably perplexed them. He said, "Look at the fields that are ripe unto harvest, and the workers, the laborers are few." And they looked around, what fields are you talking about? He wasn't talking about grass and trees and crops. He was talking about people. That's very important for us if we're going to carry the flame of the gospel, the flame of God's light into a very dark world.
One evening, it was after a prayer meeting, a Tuesday night, there was a gentleman on the street, and he hadn't said anything to me, but you could physically see that he was really in need. But I walked by him, and the Holy Spirit, as I was walking by him, I believe the Holy Spirit said, "Tell him I love him." And I kept going. I didn't stop. I never said anything. Got all the way to my car. And the Holy Spirit can be loud sometimes because he was speaking to me and said, go back and tell him I love him. And so I couldn't get in my car. I had to go back. And I went back and I told him, I said, Jesus loves you. And the man said to me, thank you. Thank you for that. Now, I've never seen that man again. I don't know why I did it. I only know that the Lord, I believe that the Lord put it upon my heart. And that was, for me, the beginning of a transformation where the Lord allowed me to begin to see people, see them on the street, see needs. The Lord really began to minister even more to me because I began to see, like, well, wow, what can I do? How can I love? How can I really help? Because everything else was kind of in a safe haven, but this really stepped me out in who the Lord is calling me to be. I had a lot of issues. issues about cleanliness, issues about smells, issues about just being afraid to talk to people. The list was real, is still long, but I've grown a great deal, praise you, Lord. And so in thinking about a lot of those issues, what the Lord did was really reveal them to me, showing me my true heart and his heart. You know, he's been teaching me about who he is and how he loves. You know, I prayed this prayer about a year and a half ago. I said, Lord, let me love the way you love. And that prayer came with an interesting new life for me because I began to see people differently, even in a new way, and continued in that love that the Lord has given to us.
We have to pray that we begin to see the world the way Jesus sees the world. More than that, we need to pray and ask God for understanding of how he feels about that world. See, there was urgency in this to Jesus. He said, look at the fields. These people are perishing. They don't know about me. And they were looking around like, what are you talking about? He said, no, the world filled with people of all races and backgrounds, all ages, rich people and poor people, Latinos, Anglos, people from every background speaking every kind of language, they are a field. They are a harvest that needs to be reaped. And most of us settle for just, I go to church on Sunday. But we have to listen to what God is telling these 70 others. They represent not apostles and pastors and teachers and evangelists. They represent just disciples of Jesus Christ, people who have received the gospel and are following the Lord, been born again through the Holy Spirit as they believed the message of the cross. So these fields were ripe unto harvest, and Jesus is telling them, you got to go because the laborers are few. There's very few laborers. Isn't that amazing? God has all power. Jesus was the Son of God, and yet he needed the cooperation of 70 people whose names we don't even know. This is a very important truth found in the Bible that is often overlooked. We know that God is sovereign. We know that God is omnipotent. He has all power. And yet, in his wisdom, in his plan for planet Earth, he has said, my message, my love, my compassion has to be conveyed by people who work with me. You know, the Apostle Paul in one place says, we're co-laborers with Christ. He, of course, is doing the saving. He's the one who died on the cross. And yet, God has chosen not to use angels speaking from heaven, loud voices coming from the clouds. No, he has said to us, you go into the fields that are ripe unto harvest. You see the need that people have. Just think of where you live right now, all the loneliness that surrounds you, the emptiness. I don't care where you live. I happen to live in New York City. I'm in downtown Brooklyn right now. But without Jesus Christ, People's lives are...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.